Back during slavery, when black people like me talked to the slaves, they didn't kill them. They sent some old house Negro along behind him to undo what he said. You have to read the history of slavery to understand this. There were two kinds of Negroes. There was that old house Negro and the field Negro. And the house Negro always looked out for his master. When the field Negroes got too much out of line, he held them back in check. He put them back on the plantation. The house Negro could afford to do that because he lived better than the field Negro. He ate better, he dressed better, and he lived in a better house. He lived right up next to his master in the attic or the basement. He ate the same food his master ate. And wore his same clothes, and he could talk just like his master, good diction. And he loved his master more than his master loved himself. That's why he didn't want his master hurt. If the master got sick, he'd say, "What's the matter, boss? We sick." When the master's house caught a fire, he'd try and put the fire out. He didn't want his master's house burned. He never wanted his master's property threatened. And he was more defensive of it than the master was. That was the house Negro. But then you had some field Negroes who lived in huts, had nothing to lose. They wore the worst kind of clothes, they ate the worst food, and they caught hell. They felt the sting of the lash. They hated their master. Oh, yes, they did. If the master got sick, they prayed that the master died. If the master's house caught a fire, they prayed for a strong wind to come along. This was the difference between the two. And today you still have house Negroes and field Negroes. Yeah. I'm a field Negro.
Was our president helping you follow the game?
He's giving me some tips. He's going to help me fit out my bracket.
And he's going to teach me cricket.
I did not run for office to be helping out a bunch of, you know, fat cat bankers on Wall Street.
But guess who gave $54 million to elect Barack Obama president? Wall Street bankers and financial insiders, more than any other candidate in history.
Helping out a bunch of, you know, fat cat bankers.
But Obama voted for the Wall Street bailout, and his White House is full of Wall Street executives.
People on Wall Street still don't get it.
Obama won't admit to supporting Wall Street, but Wall Street sure supports President Obama.
I will close Guantanamo. I will restore habeas corpus.
And one of the things I think the next president has to do is to stop fanning people's fears. You know, if we spend all our time feeding the American people fear and conflict and division, then they become fearful and conflicted and divided.
Small groups of killers have the capacity to do great harm. That was the case before 9/11, and that remains true today. ISIL is a terrorist organization, pure and simple. And it has no vision other than the slaughter of all who stand in its way. While we have not yet detected specific plotting against our homeland, ISIL leaders have threatened America and our allies. These fighters could try to return to their home countries and carry out deadly attacks.
And I'll finally end the abuse of no-bid contracts once and for all. The days of sweetheart deals for Halliburton will be over when I'm in the White House.
You will not see your taxes increase one single dime. You will not see your taxes increased a single dime.
When I'm president, meetings where laws are written will be more open to the public. No more secrecy. That's a commitment I make to you as president.
Transparency and the rule of law will be the touchstones of this president.
Back since taking office, this has been the administration that's prosecuted more whistleblowers in 2 years than in the preceding 40 years, that meets with lobbyists across the street from the White House so they don't have to disclose they're meeting with lobbyists, and, this is true, censored nearly 200 pages of internal emails about their efforts to make government more transparent.
That means no more illegal wiretapping of American citizens. No more national security letters to spy on citizens who are not suspected of a crime. No more tracking citizens who do nothing more than protest a misguided war. No more ignoring the law when it is inconvenient.